So I'm here at the Self-Healing Festival talking to David Rankin, and he's into sacred geometry. Now, tell me about you getting into sacred geometry. How did that happen?
It's a long voyage. It started off with playing the Highland bagpipes when I was a young teenager, which led into exploring the art of my culture, Celtic culture, and doing Celtic illuminated manuscript art, which then led me into exploring the art of other cultures, like the Hindu tradition and the Arabic and Jewish traditions. And then from there, looking into mandalas, and then from there into sacred geometry. From the sacred geometry, I pulled music back in. That I'd returned to music. I'd given up bagpipes. I'm a gentleman now. And involved music and graphic image and healing modality. Kind of like Reiki, but not.
So how did you get it? So tell me more about that. How did it go into that, and what did you do with it?
I took one level of training in Reiki, discovered I had a natural aptitude for it. Tried it out on a few of my teachers, and they said, well, it's like you've been doing it 30 years. Just do it. And that's what I did. I just followed what felt good. I followed my heart, followed my gut senses, and the actual energy during the healing process is revealed to me through sacred geometry. So I see cubes, I see tetrahedrons.
So through that Reiki experience, that led you into discovering sacred geometry? Is that what you're saying?
No, that pulled the sacred geometry in.
Pulled it in more.
Yeah. I said, oh, here's an application of sacred geometry. It's not just an esoteric.
Right, because you're more illuminated through the Reiki to now better appreciate these other forms. Okay, so please continue. Sorry.
So I'm always interested in the application of things. You know, just raw knowledge is useless. I want to know how it can be applied, how a mandala can be applied. It's not a piece of art. It's a process, how people can do them to heal, how people can do to tap into their own process, their own healing process, and how I can manipulate the energy like that to help somebody remember their natural setting of health.
So are the things you have here on the table, do you use that in your practice to help heal people?
Or? The graphic images, yes. So sort of indicators of...
Let's look at some of these things then.
Especially things like the coloring books. I'll encourage people to use these matrices to design their own pieces of art. So what I really am, I think, is a facilitator of sacred geometry. I don't do things to people. I just open up the space so they can remember how to do it.
So tell me more about your practice in using the sacred geometry as a mandala or whatever to help people heal themselves.
Okay. Say upon somebody presents with a certain ailment or a certain emotional issue, is to start constructing a series of geometric forms, starting with center point, circle, triangle, square, and then the three-dimensional forms, and actually thinking them out or drawing them with my hands or limbs over the person, which helps them to remember their perfection of health, the default setting, the natural setting of health, self-healing.
Wow. How long have you been doing this?
The healing? 2 years.
Okay. So what are people saying that come to you for some kind of healing and using the sacred geometry workbook and stuff like that?
How do they respond to it?
Yeah, what are they...
They're always astounded at how effective it is. Because at the root of everything is the same emotional issue. That's what I've discovered. It's always the same emotional issue. Of all the physical ailments.
Which would be...
affirmation and acknowledgement. They want to be noticed. They want to be acknowledged for who they are. Not who people say they are, what they've been programmed to believe they are, but actually who they are.
Wow.
Which is...
how insightful.
An indestructible, irreducible, limitlessly creative being with an eternal soul.
Wow. Okay, so do you want to walk me through some of these pieces here, or are they relevant to your practice?
Not really, except that much of the imagery on these pieces is the kind of imagery I work with in healing practice. Mandalas, the arrangements of various geometric forms on top of each other. The Celtic cross is a cosmogram. The the circle of unity, with the axes of, you know, heaven and earth running through them. These are all symbols that when we wear them, they just help to remind us too of the perfect, our geometric perfection, or the perfection of geometry as a metaphor for the divine and our place in the divine.
Okay, great. Your website is?
DavidRankinArt.com.
Great. Well, thank you for showing us the different angles of self-healing.